Hello friends, I welcome you to a new day. Jesus is Lord and His jurisdiction is global. Let's just give Him all the glory, give Him all the praise. It's entirely a new day. Let's join the 20 and the 4 elders, including the 4 beasts, to glorify Him, to prostrate before His majesty, and to honor Him. Let's worship Him. He is the Almighty. Beside Him is no one else. He is the fourth man in the fire. We bow before His majesty. Father, You are mighty in battle. You are the resurrection and the life. We give You glory. We give You praise. Thank You for sparing our lives to glorify You. You are the King in Zion. We give You glory. We have come to make attendance as those whom You spare their lives to glorify You in a new day. Blessed be the name of the Lord God Almighty. We lift up our banners in the name of the Lord God Almighty, and we give You the glory, we give You the praise. We've come to say You are good. We've come to declare that You are the best. You are the beauty of Zion. We reverence You, the life giver. We say thank You. You are beautiful in this season. You are beautiful forever. Thank You for providing this platform for us to worship You. Thank You for being the faithful Father. We worship You that inhabits eternity. And we lay our trophies at Your feet. We honor You, the Ancient of Days. Be magnified. Sweet Holy Spirit, we want to say we love You. You do a mighty things. Thank You, everlasting God. Thank You, the Spirit that brought forth Jesus from the grave. We celebrate You forever. Lord, we say thank You. And blessed be the name of the Lord God Almighty. For we worship with thanksgiving. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we worship. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is Spirit Praise Daily Devotional, and Spirit Praise Daily Devotional comes your way every morning to build up your spiritual capacity and network. It comes as a daily dose to strengthen your spiritual cables and wires and to keep you ablaze for God all day. And our topic for today says the spectator generation. So briefly this morning we take our Bible reading from Acts 13 verse 36, and the Bible says, "For David, after he had served his own generation by the will of God, fell on asleep and was laid unto his fathers and saw corruption." Permit me to start by saying that life is all about impact, and a life lived without impact is a waste of time and God's resources. Friends, hear me. Impact is about influence, and influence is all about your donating your service to your generation under God. You can quote me. Zikete pelegedos. Somebody on the line, hear me. The greatest thing you can give to your generation is to serve your generation. You can also quote me. As a matter of fact, there is something you have you must give to your generation. Once you are still on this side of eternity, I said there is something you have you must give to your generation. Once you are still on this side of eternity and taking in God's free oxygen. In fact, as a youth, David knew there was something he got to offer to his generation. So as a young man, he did not waste his time beating about the bush. In fact, in the bush, he went after a lion and bear and killed and conquered the both. When he finished dealing with the lion and the bear, he came out from the bush and noticed that his generation were made up of the spectators' campaign. I said they were made up of the spectators' campaign who were busy watching Goliath insulting the God of Israel. Now, permit me to say at this point that the generation that lived in the time of David, in the days when Goliath was harassing everybody, were the spectator generation. Now let me show you a bit of what I mean. I said, let me show you a bit of what I'm talking about. Follow me to 1 Samuel 17 verses 10 to 11, and I read, "And the Philistine said, I defy the armies of Israel this day. Give me a man that we fight together. And when Saul and all Israel heard those words of the Philistine, they were dismayed and greatly afraid." Chai, can you imagine that? So friends, Goliath boasted in his strength, not knowing that a mighty man is not delivered by much strength or by his boastings. He boasted in the name of his gods. The gods who cannot offer help to themselves. Talk more of delivering Goliath. So as Goliath made boast of his power to tear and kill, everybody in the generation of David was just looking. In fact, I call them the Lucre generation. Friend, I said I call them the Lucre generation. If you can allow me to use that term. As they were busy looking, David stood up. I said David stood up and said, in 1 Samuel 17 verse 32, and I read, "And David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. The servant will go and fight with this Philistine." Now hear this, friend. There is a generation to serve, and you must rise up and fight. I said you must rise up and fight so you can serve them. Of course, you know that David fought all through his lifetime, but never lost any battle. I said he fought through all his lifetime and never lost any battle. And someone is asking, what happened? What happened was that David got up and said, I will not join this generation of spectators to watch. Rather, I will deal with this loafer called Goliath, who chose to insult the God of Israel. I said, David said, I will arise. I will deal with this loafer called Goliath, who chose to insult the God of Israel. Friends, David was like, this is the best opportunity to serve my generation. I'm not gonna let it pass by like a roving bird. I'm going to confront this giant that is insulting my God, not by my strength, but by the strength of the Most High God, the God of Israel. So David went in the name of the Lord God Almighty and conquered Goliath at the age of 17. I said he went in the name of the Lord God Almighty and conquered the giant called Goliath. Kai, someone on the line, you are yet to deal with the Goliath of your generation, even though you are above the age of 17. Kai, someone is asking, Barrister Joy, which Goliath? Wait a minute, I'm talking about the Goliath of sexual immorality, the Goliath of pornography, the Goliath of masturbation, of lesbianism, of falsehood, adultery, idolatry, stealing, rape, jealousy, envy, unforgiveness, backbiting, bitterness, wickedness, too numerous to mention. And hear me, someone on the line, you cannot serve your generation effectively until you conquer the Goliath of your generation. You can quote me. Now hear this, forget all those noise making everywhere. You cannot serve your generation by flesh. Mbano, I said no. For the Bible says in 1 Samuel 2 verse 9b, and I read, for by flesh shall no man prevail. As we pray, I came to encourage you to maximize the opportunity of your being on this side of eternity to serve your generation. Because that's the reason why you are still enjoying his free oxygen up till now. Listen to me. You are saved to save and serve others. And there is a generation to serve. David served his own generation according to the will of God, not according to his own pattern or his own style or design. Can I let you know that a generation is waiting, and it will be an error for you to be giving excuses till the game is over. I said it will be an error for you to be giving excuses till the game is over. Some people today are in the company of those people who will say, God, I will do it. I will do it for you in the next 10 months. 10 months comes and goes. I will do it in the next 5 years, and it will not be done. After 5 years, God, I will do it for you. I will do it in the next 7 years for you. And 7 years will come and go, and it will not be done. Friend, God sent me this morning to ask you, for how long will you dwell in procrastination? Kai, I said, for how long will you dwell in procrastination? This message this morning is for someone on the line. And God is saying, arise and give to your generation what they cannot give to themselves. For time is fleeting fast. Hear me. There is a generation to serve, and they are waiting for you. I said they are waiting and may not wait forever. This is the time and the urgency in the heavenlies declares that there is a generation to serve. Now is the time to leave your signature of impact on the documents of human history. Don't delay further. For the generation to serve is waiting. Let us pray. Hear me, friends. The first step to serve your generation is to surrender your life to Jesus. So I plead on a listener to this broadcast to please give your life to Jesus as time is running out. Now quickly say after me. I encourage you, if you are a backslider, please join them. Now say after me. My Father in heaven, I come to you this day. I am a sinner. Lord Jesus, please forgive me. Please grant me your pardon. Come into my heart. Be my Lord and my personal Savior. Give me the power and the grace to live for you and to serve you for the rest of my days. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for saving me. No going back. Say it as you mean it. No going back. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus Christ's matchless name we prayed. Amen. And I decree and declare to everyone who has just made this prayer that this decision you have just taken today shall forever remain permanent. In Jesus Christ's precious name we prayed. Amen. Since let's go. I would like us to do this song together. If you know it, please join me. Let's do it together as we proceed in the place of prayer. Here am I. Send me. Zikete pelegedosh. Here am I. Send me. For the Lord wants somebody. Zikete pelagadosh. Here am I. Send me. Here am I. Send me to my generation. Here am I. Send me. Zinekenenemos ikrakatapa legedus. For the Lord wants somebody. Here am I. Jesus, here am I. Send me. Here am I to my generation. Send me. Somebody sing. Here am I to your generation. God, send them. I say, here am I, Jesus, send me. Friends, a generation to serve is waiting. Let's go. You cannot fail God in this great season. I said no. Receive capacity to respond to the call of your generation. Somebody go in the Holy Ghost. Mystery to mystery. A generation is waiting. I say go in the Holy Ghost. Heaven is watching. I say heaven is watching. A generation is waiting. Young person on the line, what are you waiting for? Your generation is waiting for you. I say, what are you waiting for? Youth, what are you waiting for? Avoid belonging to the spectator generation. I said, avoid belonging to the spectator generation. No spiritual wire should be weak. Now is the time to respond to the call of your generation, to the cry of your generation. I said, now is the time to serve your generation. Somebody go in the Holy Ghost. Don't be around, and God is looking for me. That is an error. I said, don't be around, and God is looking for vessels. Receive capacity on this global prayer altar this morning to respond to the call and the urgency of your generation. Respond to the call and the cry of your generation, my friend. Now is the time. A generation is waiting. And they will not wait forever. Respond to the call of urgency. I say, somebody pray. Time is running out. The time to serve your generation is now, according to the will of God. Not according to your own will or pattern. According to the will of God. You will not disappoint God. I said you will not disappoint Jehovah. Father, we give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Here we are on this global prayer altar this morning as volunteers. Send us to our generation. Send every man, every woman on this global prayer altar this morning. I said, send every man, send every woman to his or her generation, even in this great season, to answer the question, being raised by their generation, to respond to the cry of their generation. Thank you, my Father. Thank you for hearing our prayers on this global prayer altar this morning. Thank you for spirit praise. daily devotional. Thank you for what you are doing. Thank you for the armies you are raising. End time armies for your glory. Thank you for the last time revival we see. We return the glory. For our lives are never the same. Be exalted, my Father, and reign forever, the King that never dies. And I decree and declare to everyone who has listened to this broadcast that from today, God will not look for men and women when you are still around. I said he will not look for men and women. He will not look for youth. He will not look for young men and women. He will never look for vessels. He will not look for the old. He will not look for the ancient. He will not look for the modern. While you are still around. But from today, you shall respond to the cry of your generation. Thank you, our God. In Jesus Christ's precious name, I decree. Amen. Thank you, my Father. Thank you for the open heavens on this global prayer altar. Thank you for the access we have to where you dwell. Go serve your generation in accordance with the will of God, in partnership with the Holy Spirit.